Crypto correction is not over. This is just the beginning. About a month ago, I issued a warning saying that cryptos are in the midst of correction. At the time, Bitcoin price was around 42,000. Now it is traded at around 34,000. And I still believe that there is more room for correction. In my opinion, Bitcoin price and crypto prices in general will drop around 70% from the respective all-time high. A 70% decrease from Bitcoin's all-time high puts us at around 20,000 per Bitcoin, which is, coincidentally or not, also the peak Bitcoin reached during its previous run back in 2017. There are a number of reasons why I think that cryptos will continue dropping in value. The most obvious one is because cryptos in general and Bitcoin in particular just ran up way too high, way too fast. And the current usefulness of cryptos, or lack thereof, simply can't justify such high valuations. Now, don't get me wrong, I like cryptos, Ethereum, Bitcoin, certainly not all cryptos, most of them are total shit. And I do believe that top cryptos will reach new all-time highs at some point, but not yet. First, a number of things need to happen. Crypto adoption needs to increase to justify high valuations. ESG issues needs to be addressed for institutions to adopt cryptos. And of course, we need better regulatory clarity on cryptos. Without regulatory clarity, cryptos will forever remain highly risky, speculative assets. Countries such as China and Turkey cracking down on cryptos certainly doesn't help crypto prices. And it appears that Coinbase co-founder shares some of my concerns. As Bitcoin charts show, the price 50-day moving average has fallen below the 200-day moving average, a pattern known as the death cross. Coinbase co-founder Fred Ersem has warned most cryptocurrencies and crypto assets won't work, and 90% of NFTs will have little to no value in the 3 to 5 years. Well, isn't that a surprise? And I spoke about this before. There's just way too many cryptocurrencies. Most of them are not going to work. Most of them are going to fail. Most of them are total shit. So be careful out there. Well, isn't that rich? Now Mark Cuban calls for crypto regulation after the price of Iron Titanium token suddenly crashes to zero. Mark Cuban is the biggest pumper of crypto, and he says that he got hit like everyone else, but I don't believe that. I'm sure that he got out before the crash. But anyways, I digress. Alright, back to the story. People are going to try all sorts of things. Ersem, who has gone on to fund the blockchain investment firm Paradigm since leaving Coinbase in 2017, told Bloomberg this week, warning many of those smaller cryptocurrencies won't survive. Of course they won't, that's a very obvious statement. There will be millions and millions of cryptocurrencies and crypto assets, just like there were millions and millions of websites, most of them won't work. Coinbase, the San Francisco-based Bitcoin and cryptocurrency exchange, went public this year at a huge $100 billion valuation, but has since seen its market cap plummet, falling by a third amid waning interest among retail traders and global regulatory pressure. Since Bitcoin was created in 2009, thousands of cryptocurrencies have been created, with crypto data provider CoinMarketCap currently counting just over 10,000 different coins. Unbelievable, 10,000 coins. Ersem said that 90% will fail. I say that at least 99% will fail. Most of them will fail. Like the vast majority will fail for sure. Some, such as Ethereum, the second largest cryptocurrency after Bitcoin, with a market capitalization of $250 billion compared to Bitcoin's $660 billion, have established themselves as cryptocurrency mainstays, while others, including EOS and more recently Internet Computer, have made splashy debuts only to fade away over time. Internet Computer's ICP token is down over 90% from its all-time high price set shortly after its launch in May, while EOS, which made headlines when it raised $4.1 billion ahead of its launch in 2018, is trading 80% lower. Well, isn't that amazing? There are some also warn against investors betting on NFTs, non-fungible tokens. The popularity of NFTs that use cryptocurrency technology to allow all manner of digital real estate from artwork to tweets, memes, and YouTube videos to be tokenized and sold via blockchain has exploded over the last few months, though data suggests the market is already significantly down on its early May peak. Alright, so there you have it. I think there's still room for correction in cryptocurrencies. Of course, I can be wrong. Please do your own due diligence. Now, before I go, I want to leave you with a short video explaining the key warning signs in financial bubbles. As always, feel free to like, comment, and subscribe, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao.
It's hard to talk about investments these days without hearing the word bubble.
We have an asset bubble.
So I don't think we've got a broad bubble.
Historically, it's indicative of a bubble type environment.
You look at Bitcoin, it doesn't have any income. So it's a pure speculative self-fulfilling bubble.
But for all the talk, how can we tell what's a bubble and what's not? And what happens if it is a bubble and it bursts? Morgan Stanley's Ruchir Sharma decided to go back in history, analyzing the 10 biggest bubbles over the last century, everything from the U.S. stock market in 1929 to Chinese shares in 2015. And what they had in common was a price that rose 100% in the year before they peaked, with much of the gain packed into frenzied trading in the last few months, as day traders and other latecomers came rushing in. So, if history is a guide, where do we see those traits today? Ruchir Sharma says SPACs certainly make the cut.
I think that SPACs are very much here to stay.
Clearly, there's a lot of hype.
As do cryptocurrencies.
I think Bitcoin will be somewhere between, 40 and 55,000 for the next chapter before it kind of builds up enough new momentum to take out that 55,000 and end the year much higher.
But some people insist that far from a bubble, crypto is actually a hedge.
If you're looking for a safe haven, I see Bitcoin as the most secure, most reliable, most certain thing in the entire economic universe.
If things like SPACs and crypto do prove to be real bubbles, things could get ugly. As Ruchir Sharma's work shows, historically, when bubbles burst, they take roughly 70% of the asset's value with them. But Sharma admits that it just may be different this time, given how much liquidity there is in the market and a commitment from central banks to easy money, the likes of which we've never seen before.
Now really the focus is on, can we make sure that the liquidity that's gone into the system, the support that's been provided, translates into long-term sustainable growth.